Did you know that opioid medication and medication combinations are not among the most effective or long-lasting of the options available for relief of acute dental pain? In addition, opioid medication and medication combinations are associated with higher rates of acute adverse events. Safe and effective pain management is an essential goal of all the dental practitioners. You did a dental procedure on a patient and the patient experiences unbearable pain. Guess what? The patient does not turn up for the next appointment. Now let's think of another situation where a patient comes to you with an excruciating pain. You give the patient the right medication with or without an intervention. What next? The patient will remember you for his lifetime because patients do not forget extreme painful situations and incidents that are related to it. Well, hello, namaskar, and good evening. I'm Dr. Paritosh, your host for today's evening show, that is Radiotherapy Channel 32. The series of radio-based podcasts that I upload every weekend on my YouTube channel, that is The Internet Dentist, and also I'm available on Instagram and Facebook page by the same name. And today's talk is all about painkillers in dentistry, wherein I'm going to share with you the best painkillers which will relieve extreme dental pain backed by scientific evidence. The study that we are going to be discussing today is because it was requested by the ADA, that is American Dental Association, and was later on published in the Journal of American Dental Association in the year of 2018. The study aimed not only to assess the benefits but also the harms associated with all the painkillers that were incorporated or included in the study. It was also expected that the study outcomes will be able to help the dentist in better clinical decision making. Although most data in adults presented here in the study is derived from the study of third molar extraction, the results are more broadly applicable because comparable findings for relief of pain of endodontic origin also. So the results for the adult population that included more than 460 individual studies and more than 58,000 patient population showed that patients who were more likely to experience treatment benefit were the ones who were receiving 400 milligrams of ibuprofen in a combination with 1000 mg of acetaminophen, that is paracetamol. The next drug or medication combination that was giving the maximum benefit next to the previous combination that I told you was 200 mg of ibuprofen plus 500 mg of acetaminophen, that is paracetamol. Drug number 3 or the third combination that was most effective in providing pain relief was 1000 mg of acetaminophen in combination with 10 mg of oxycodone. The duration of post-operative pain relief was maximum with 1000 mg of diflunisal, that was for 10.9 hours. 9.9 hours was for 650 mg of acetaminophen, that is paracetamol, and 10 mg of oxycodone combined. The third drug or combination that was giving the maximum duration of pain relief was 9.8 hours with 500 mg of diflunisal and 8.9 hours of 500 to 550 mg of naproxen. The adverse events that were related with the painkillers were drowsiness, respiratory depression, nausea, vomiting, and constipation for the opioid medications, and drowsiness, dizziness, nausea, headache for the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, that is NSAIDs. The painkillers in this study that proved to be the safest as a painkiller given in the dental patients was ibuprofen 200 mg and 100 mg of caffeine with the least adverse events. Also, opioids showed to be having significantly greater number of adverse events as compared to placebo when it comes to dental pain relief. And the two combinations of ibuprofen and acetaminophen at dosages of 200 mg by 500 mg and 400 mg by 1000 mg were observed to have statistically fewer adverse events. So today's discussion was entirely based on the painkillers, and the studies that we were discussing was only meant for adults. Maybe in the next round of podcast, I'll be selecting studies that will be relevant to the children patients or pediatric patients as well. And until next time, goodbye, adios, sayonara, and good night. Please carry me, carry me, carry me home. I've spent all of the love I saved. We were always a losing game. Small town boy in a big arcade. I got addicted to a losing.
this roller coaster.